Hello and welcome to Volley Vault. Today we're going to talk about 4-2 advanced formation. The next step in my evolution of volleyball formations is the same exact concept like 4-2 formation, but with a little differences in between. Now that you know the basics of 4-2 formation and what it's all about, we're going to mention just the differences between this and the 4-2 formation in each rotation. It sounds a little intricate, but it really is a form of basics 4-2 formation with additional role to it. First, we're adding that the setter does not go into a position number 3, but in a position number 2. I'm going to explain that in a little bit. Secondly, we're changing 2 receivers to a middle hitter, and these 2 changes add much difference to a game. The last, just for a preparation sake, we send the setter that is in the second line to a position number 1 where it's going to play the defense. Let's run through these changes one by one. By moving setter to a position number 2 and adding a middle hitter to a position number 3, attack of our team is not just at left and right side, but left and middle, with additions to attack we can organize to the sides and with the second line attack. We're adding quick, fast attack near the setter with an option to be fake and to go wide into attacker on the left sideline. We're also leaving the option to a middle attacker that goes to the side and attack as before, or with the girls' option to use Korea and attack quickly from the right sideline. Setter with specialized options on the position number 2 will start to prepare for the upcoming professional formations. This opens up more specializations to the game, since now we have 3 specialized positions: setters, the triangles; middle hitters, the squares; and the receivers, the circles. Let's jump to visualize our new formation. As you can see in the picture, on rotation 1, setter is on position number 3, and he or she is changing the place with the player on the position number 2, where the middle hitter is. This happens when our team is serving, so that our setter is on the right side to play the defense. When the team is on receiving, the setter can stay between positions 2 and 3 and wait for the receive, while middle hitter is on the 3-meter line at the right and the receiver is on the left 3-meter line. When we are serving, in the second rotation, first setter is at the position number 2 and he or she doesn't move, just stays near the net. The second middle hitter is at the position number 4 and he pulls back near the 3-meter line on the right. For the first receiver, he is at the position number 3. He can pull back to the right and perform an attack from the right side. There are also a few combinations that we are going to present to you for you to experiment with your team. Not every combination is for every team. In this example, we see a position shift of the receiver, the orange, and the setter, green, in the second line to leave the room for the receiver from the first line to receive and get a better approach for the attack from the left sideline. In this case, the middle hitter on the left sideline will usually go for an attack from the middle near the set. In the second example, the first receiver is going directly backward, a little deeper than 3-meter line. From there, after receiving, he goes at position number 2 or position number 4 to attack. More on that in the next chapters. The third rotation allows the second setter, green triangle, to become the first one and do his job, while the first one goes to the serve and becomes the second setter. As soon as the second setter, now yellow triangle, serves, first setter goes into position number 2 to play the defense, and from there receiver goes to his place, position number 4. Middle hitter stays where he or she is. For the receiving, setter stays at his left corner near the net and waits for the opponent's serve to hit the ball and starts the rally and then runs into his play position number 2. Middle hitter pulls all the way left at 3-meter line near the setter. The receiver stays at the right side, receives if needed, and gets ready for the attack at the position number 2. After the attack, he or she shifts to a position number 4 for defense and the next attack. As the second receiver is at the position number 5, he or she must shift to a position number 6 to attack from the middle back row and leave the room for the second middle hitter, who also shifts from position number 6 to position number 5. The second setter, that is at position number 1, stays there to be near the first setter and maybe attack from the right back row. In this rotation, there is a variation that you may add as a progress toward 5-1 formation. It's a little change in the receiving position of the first receiver, the red circle. As you see in this picture, the receiver goes from the right all the way back to the left row. As the middle hitter, the receiver needs to be further from the left sideline than the middle hitter to not break the rotation. There is also one more thing. I have left one mistake on the picture for you to find it. And when you do, leave us a comment what that is. I'm hoping you will find it. It's easy. This rotation is practically the same as the first, but now the second setter is at the position number 3. The rest of the players are going to arrange on the court as the previous rotation you have seen. The rotation number 5 has the same formation as rotation number 2 with different players in the first line. Rotation number 6 has the first setter back onto the first line and the second setter is serving. The rest of the players are at diagonals of their positions at the rotation number 3. As you may see in the preview, in this formation you can have much more free play, numerous combinations for attacking, much higher rate in defending, and narrow down responsibilities for players, teaching them to play setter from position number 2 and making a few more combinations for your team's attack slowly introduces them to our next formation. So this is all for this video. I hope you like it and I hope you will try to transition from 4-2 to 4-2 advanced, and then we can go on into our next formation of 5-1. I hope you like it, enjoyed it, and as always, have a great volleyball day.